Hello everyone, hope you all are fine and might be missing your English class. Well, in that case, I, Harshika Kain, your English teacher, is back again with a new chapter of Mulberry, that is chapter number 2, The Royal Gift. Chapter number 2, The Royal Gift, is a story about a young princess of China who helped her father and his mandarins means official rank holders in Chinese service, or we can say that they are clever people who help the emperor. So the princess of China helped her father and his mandarins to weigh an elephant, which was a gift for him from King of India. Before starting the chapter, we can see that an activity is given here. This is your homework. You have to find the answers of this activity, and you need not do this activity in your classwork copies. Instead, you have to write the answers on a rough paper or in rough copy. And once you all are having the book and we are back in our school, we will match our answers there. So, what is the activity about? People in ancient China invented, means first made, lots of things that we use today. Look at the picture closely and name at least 8 things that the Chinese invented. So, a picture is given to you and you have to look the picture carefully and list 8 things which you think were invented by the Chinese. So let us start the chapter. Let us read a story about a young princess of China. Long ago in China, a mighty emperor, mighty means very strong and powerful emperor, means the king, the ruler, he received a gift. Received means he got something that was sent for him from the ruler of another land. Now we can see that a picture is given here that depicts the story. A servant enters and the ruler is sitting there, and two more people, or we can say his mandarins, are standing here. So what is the conversation that they are having? We will read it. Your Majesty, I have come with a gift for you from my king in India. So, a servant enters and he informed the ruler that he is having a gift for him from the king of India. Your Majesty means these are the terms which are used to respect or show respect to a king or ruler. A gift? Where is it? Have it brought here. So, on listening that he got a gift, the emperor asked the servant to bring that gift inside. I can't bring it inside, Your Majesty. Please come outside to see it. Now, the servant replied that he cannot bring that gift inside, but the ruler, means he, have to come outside to see that gift. The emperor and his mandarins walked out to see the gift. Now they all came out of the royal court to see that gift. Here it is. What is that? I have never seen anything so big in all my life. Now, after looking at the gift, the king was surprised and he made a statement that he had never seen anything so big in all his life. It is called an elephant, my lord. So the servant replied to him that it is an elephant, my lord, is another way of showing respect to a king. It looks like a hill that has come to life and walked here. The king compared the elephant to a hill, because he has never seen anything so big in his life, and he thought of an elephant is like a hill, and that hill has come to life and walked here. The royal court was full of excitement. Word quickly spread throughout the land about the enormous creature. There was one question that everyone was asking: how much does the elephant weigh? Now, the royal court was full of excitement, and everyone was aware of that enormous creature. Enormous creature means very big, very large creature, animal, throughout the land, and everyone wanted to know the answer to only question, that is, how much does the elephant weigh? Means they all were curious to know the answer of only one question, that is, about how much the elephant weigh, or what is the weight, or how much is the weight of that elephant. The emperor was curious too. He and his mandarins discussed it all day long. Curious means he also wanted to know about that creature, and he, along with his mandarins, discussed about it the whole day. "We have no scales in the land large enough to weigh him." Now, the king said that they have no scales. Scales means it is a tool used for weighing people or things. Like you go to a shop, and if you ask for something, and that shopkeeper measure it on a scale. So, the king said that we have no scale in the land large enough to weigh him. Means they have no scale in their entire land which could weigh that elephant. "Even if we had the scales, where would we hang them?" Now, another mandarin replied that even if they were having scales, the problem is that where they would hang them. "The strongest tree branch would break under the weight." Now, another mandarin replied, "If they are planning to hang the scale on a tree, then the strongest tree branch would also break because of the weight. It is impossible to weigh the elephant." The emperor's daughter heard them talking. She walked up to her father and tugged. Tugged means pulled something hard at his royal robe. Now, what happened when they were talking, the king and his mandarins, they were discussing how to weigh that elephant. It was heard by the little princess. She went to her father and pulled his robe. Royal robe means it is a garment normally worn by emperors, like a sign of or a symbol of authority. Now, what she say? "Father, I know of a way to weigh the elephant." Now, she tells her father that she has a way about how to weigh an elephant. "You, my daughter." Now, king was surprised. "Come with me and I'll show you how to weigh the elephant." Now, she asks her father to come with her, and she will tell him how she can weigh that elephant. The little princess took her father and the mandarins to the riverside. There was a big sturdy boat there. Sturdy means something that will not break easily, or it is very strong enough. So they all went to a riverside, and there was a big strong boat standing there. "First, put the elephant into the boat." Now she started directing the mandarins how to weigh the elephant. First, she asked them to put the elephant into the boat. "Then, see how deep the boat goes into the water." Now, she asked them, after putting the elephant into the boat, she asked the mandarins to notice about the level or the portion of the boat that will immerse into the water when the elephant is inside the boat. "Make a mark on the side of the boat to show how much the boat sinks. Now, once the boat has managed a level in the water, then she asks them to mark a point there or a line there on the boat to show that that portion of the boat was in the water or immersed into the water when the elephant was in the boat. Bring the elephant back on land. Then after marking a point there on the boat, she asked them to bring the elephant back onto the land. Now, gather some large stones and put them into the boat till the boat sinks to the level of the mark. Now, she asked the mandarins to collect some large big stones and put them into the boat until the boat reaches to the same level of the mark which they made previously when the elephant was inside the boat. Weigh the stones one by one on the scales. Now, once they reach the same level of the mark, she asked to collect and take out all the stones which are now in the boat and weigh each stone separately on the scale. Finally, when we add the weight of the stones, we get the weight of the elephant. It is as simple as that. Now, lastly, she says that if they add the weight of each stone which they weighed separately, they will get the weight of that elephant. Well done, my princess. That is a very clever idea indeed. Now, King became very happy, and in his happiness, he applauded his daughter for that clever idea. Thank you, father. Can you guess how much the elephant weighs? Now, the daughter, the princess, thanked her father and she asked him if he could guess about the weight of that elephant. And the fame of the emperor's daughter traveled far and wide. Fame means to be known by many people. So, because of her wise act, this clever idea, she became very famous far and wide. So, students, after reading the story, we can say that the moral of the story is that sometimes young people can also give solution for the problems which grown-up people finds difficult to solve. Like in this story, the king find it difficult how to weigh that enormous creature, that elephant, which he has not seen in his life before. Then his daughter, little princess, she showed him the way how to weigh that elephant. So, students, after reading and explaining the chapter, it's time for some homework now. Your homework is to read the chapter again and learn the word meanings and try to solve book exercises. You have to read this chapter again, learn the word meanings given in your book, and try to solve the exercises given in the book. So with this, our today's class is over. I hope you all might have enjoyed the class and understood the chapter very well. We will meet again soon in the next part of this chapter, that is part 2, where we will be discussing the word meanings and some of the exercises of this chapter. Till then, complete all your homework and stay safe. Thank you and have a nice day.